story of our people. Folk, the people, law, the stories.
That's right. Folklore is what we're talking about this morning. This morning we're going to chat about the Film Folklore Festival, which is happening actually this weekend. It's kicking off today. And to help us do that, of course, I want to welcome the founder of the festival, festival manager, my apologies, Donnell Wills, and the head of public relations at Digicel TNT Limited, Mr. Colin Graves. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you guys for being here with us. Now, Donnell, tell me about the transformation that you guys had to make in terms of, you know, the pandemic and all that, and having to go fully digital.
It was a bit challenging, but last year we got practice, because last year as well we had COVID when we were hosting the festival and we had to have a virtual showcase. So we were already prepared for this year. This year we were supposed to be hybrid, where we would have had in-person sessions, but due to the COVID lockdowns, we came virtual and we were already prepared to go to that avenue. And we were able to get Digicel to come and partner with us, who is an excellent platform for distribution of digital content, because they have a very wide reach.
They definitely do. Now, Colin, tell me about you guys jumping on board, because the Film Folklore Festival has been happening and it's been, I mean, fantastic. I know the first one up on Chancellor blew everybody's mind in general.
Yeah.
And, you know, you guys have been growing from strength to strength, but why did Digicel decide to jump on board and offer this service for free to everybody?
Well, the thing is, you know, Digicel remains one of TNT's biggest fans, if I may say it that way. You know, we really love the culture in Trinidad and Tobago, and we take every opportunity to support the culture, and I mean the wealth of cultural talent that exists here in TNT. And we've done it through our carnival sponsorships, we've done it through the maintenance of all of the artists that are our brand ambassadors, and of course now we're doing it through bringing great film content to people. You know, as a digital operator, we continue to bring and power these powerful digital experiences, and it's no secret that that's where the world is now. Everyone is online, everyone is using their devices, and you know, at Digicel, for our suite of apps plus our Digicel Plus home and entertainment offering, we think that we definitely have an ideal platform with hundreds of thousands of customers that are able to have this content streamed directly to their devices. So on our Playgo app, the festival is going to live there. So for the next, not just this weekend, but beyond that, for the next couple weekends, you know, everyone in Trinidad and Tobago, not just the Digicel customers, every single person can go out there, download the Playgo app, and you can view all 100 plus titles associated with the festival.
And it's free to download the app?
Yeah, it's free to download the app. All of the content is free. You can view all of the videos for free. Schedules will be coming out every day in terms of suggested watch lists and stuff like that. And then in addition to that, with our Digicel Plus home and entertainment customers, all over 100,000 households also going to get the content for free via our video on demand platform. So people just literally take their TV remotes, go to their VOD area on their TVs with Digicel Plus, and you're inside. You're in the Film Folklore Festival for absolutely free. I'm getting all of the great films by talents from all over the world, including Trinidad and Tobago.
Well, this is what I was just about to ask Donnell about, because I know, I mean, that's one thing to say that, you know, we have all this content and it's going to be free, but we need people to understand the value of these stories. These are our stories. These are folk stories. So Donnell, tell us a little bit about some of the movies that are going to be shown inside the festival.
Well, we have a little something for everyone. We are covering as much genres as possible. There's drama, there's thrillers, there's animation, there's romance, because we are hitting countries. We have over 100 stories from countries all over the world, and countries that, you know, it would be very fun and informative to learn about. Countries like Czech Republic, Iran, India, places that you don't usually see films from. And here it is, where we are based in folklore and stories. You are getting to learn about the culture, you're getting to learn about the religious aspects, you're getting to learn about the traditions of a country. So it's a little more intimate when it comes to getting this information and stories from countries around the world.
Was it difficult to access these stories from other people? How did y'all get these films to be a part of the festival?
Well, we send out a call to filmmakers to send in their films, and it was astounding how many responses we got. We had to go through so many films and choose which films will make the cut to come onto this platform because we want it to be of a certain quality. You know, we don't want persons usually say local films, you know, they tend to be a little more on the lower end, and we don't want that. We want it to be that when they see it, it's like, wow, we want to watch local films. This is something that is fun and engaging and full 100.
How do the filmmakers, are the filmmakers benefiting from this at all? Are they being paid for their films? Is it a kind of content sharing? How does it work?
Well, we do have a competition where we are having filmmakers. It's a 1-minute short competition where we are trying to give back to the filmmakers. Mm-hmm. So that's the way that we are trying to give back. So they can enter, they were able to enter 1-minute short where we would choose 3 winners and they would be given financial prize as well as items.
Okay, fantastic. Now, Colin, are you guys going to have to like ramp up your platform because the entire Trinidad and Tobago is going to be watching the Film Folklore Festival starting from this weekend? Are you guys, do you guys have the power to stand this?
Of course. I mean, Rocker, so for the last year, you know, we've seen all of the increases in internet demand and usage as the entire country moves to working from home and homeschooling. Yeah. And, you know, you're dealing with a world-class network and world-class apps. And, you know, the great thing is that we have a really fantastic technical team working behind the scenes and across the entire Digicel group to make sure that the Playgo app, as well as our Digicel Plus platform, can definitely give you the best streaming experience this weekend and beyond. Because remember, the films are going to live on there for a while so that you can really have some great opportunities with your family and friends to, you know, go online. And also, we're also using our Bitbit Messenger app to kind of keep people in the know of what's going on throughout the festival. So you can download the Bit Messenger app, search for the Folklore Film Festival channel. The links will be on our social media pages as well as on the film festival's pages. And there, people are going to get the opportunity to get behind the scenes images and looks, meet some of the filmmakers, you know, get more in-depth knowledge of what's going on. And of course, the schedule of all the films, of our suggested viewing list. Like, you know, you can have great conversations and have your friends and families view the films at the same time over the next
like a group watch kind of vibes. Everybody watching together.
Yeah, basically, exactly. Yeah.
Well, guys, congratulations. I think this is a fantastic move to be able to have people access the festival a lot easier and safely at home. So congratulations to both Donald Wills, the festival manager of the Film and Folklore Festival, and Colin Graves, head of public relations at Digicel. Thank you guys for joining us this morning. And I look forward to watching. I'm going to spend the weekend in front of the TV. So,
yes,
I know.
Just, thank you.
Yeah. It's just how
you know, this weekend is Indian Arrival Day, right? So we have a lot of course. Really great Indian-based films and folklore as well. So I'm going to challenge you and we're going to have a view off, right?
No problem. No problem. All right, guys. Enjoy the rest of your day. Take care.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.
Folklore. Fragments of memories. Old world meeting new. Africa, Europe, Amerindia. Stories combined. Creole stories in a long time more like
film folklore festival.